CBDC is now live in Nigeria. CBDC is now live in Jamaica, in the Bahamas.
Blood clot. This not something right.
In Grenada, where my family's from, and in 7 other nations in the Eastern Caribbean bloc.
Look at fuck boy, that me telling you.
The Bank of Jamaica will roll out, as we said before, our own digital currency. We are taking decisive steps towards achieving our vision of becoming a digital society and making Jamaica the technology hub of innovation, the Silicon Valley of the region. We are on track to implement the National Digital Identification System, the NIDS, this year. This is a critical key element for financial inclusion.
You get fucked, boy, that me telling
you. It is a critical and a key element for the virtualization of services.
Well, everyone, you have just heard it from the horse's mouth, per se. Central bank digital currency is in Jamaica, and it will be in full force when it comes to everyone's finances. Now, let me explain something to most of you that don't or already know. This will be the end of using cash in Jamaica as we know it. Now, if my memory and calculation serves me well, most of the Jamaica citizens uses cash in their day-to-day lives, and many don't even go to the banks to do transactions. The majority of Jamaican citizens are so poor that as they get the money in their hands, they spend it on food and necessities right away. So, that cash does not reach the banking system. Now, let me spell it out for you. Around 72% of Jamaicans get paid by cash, while the rest is entangled in the normal pay structure of the system, aka the man. So, a person that gets paid by cash not only avoid going to the banks, but also avoid paying taxes as well. Now here comes the central bank digital currency. This means that there will be no more cash transaction nor interactions. Everyone will need to be paid in digital currency, so now all monies will be tracked by the central bank and government, aka Big Brother. So, now here comes the hell and powder house madness, as how Jamaicans would say it. If the 72% of Jamaicans that uses cash now gets forced in some way to go to a digital monetary tracked system, guess what will happen? It will be hell from here on out. Think about it. What profession in Jamaica makes up the large majority of cash transactions? The higgler dem, of course. Yes, I said it. The higgler dem. So now you are talking about all higglers of Jamaica will need to now register a business in order to be paid by any digital currency, while the other cash earners have to now work for registered job entities. Let's listen to a few statements from the online social media.
Well, let me bring you up to speed. Folks, central bank digital currencies are now live in 11 countries across the globe. CBDC is now live in Nigeria. CBDC is now live in Jamaica, in the Bahamas, in Grenada, where my family's from, and in 7 other nations in the Eastern Caribbean bloc. In short, they are being tested on black developing nations. Currently, if Jane wants to buy makeup from Sephora, Jane will use cash, debit, or credit, all transactions of which are completely private. Only Jane and her institutions can see or view those transactions. With a CBDC, Jane's transactions are no longer private. At any time, Jane's government can view Jane's transactions. Financially speaking, she is no longer a private citizen. Here's how we can stop CBDCs from being implemented. Simply sharing the information with family and friends goes further than you know. Having a bad opinion about CBDCs goes further than you know, because if we are aware of what's going on around the world with it, then we're better equipped to fight against it once it comes ashore. The Bank of Canada has actually opened up a portal that will be open, I believe, till June 19th, so it's a very short window, where they're actually taking public consultations and public opinion about the issue.
Blood clot. This not something right. The slave them, the boss is slave them, still at Jamaica. I make all kind of sitting and impose upon them because they lost their way, they lost God, they lost their spirituality. While them say, couple weeks time, Jamaica will be full digital, blood clot, digital currency. Jamaica reaches out. Yo, but I'm telling you something, you know. No loss, you know, way, or no evil. So therefore, evil are rich, you know. The state of Florida said them no want that in them state. Whole heap of first world country. A lick out them say no need it because an evil agenda if you take away your freedom. If you take away your freedom and look at a little bit of Jamaica where they have God, it will reach Jamaica before any other place. Because guess what? The people in there are asleep. All they want a flask of rum, a buckle of boom, a flag and a t-shirt. You know, get fucked, boy, that me I tell you no. You know, better wake the fuck up. I mean, never say wake up on the dead like dog. Jamaica, you can't remember Jamaica this. Everywhere else over the world, you know, the reason why they were pushing Jamaica so fast, they realize on the fall for anything and take any fucking thing. But me say, you know, see nothing yet, you know, blood clot, you know, fucking idiot, bossy slaves. They cuss out on the blood clot. Big up the few people, the 1% or so are gone. Prepare physically, spiritually, mentally, yeah, man.
Ultimately, cash is king. I mean, if you can hold it in your hand, you have power over that. The minute it's all digitized, somebody else is going to have control over that. And it's just a question of, are they going to let you live your life? Or are they going to decide to do things to circumvent what you want to do? And think about what we've already seen in Canada. You remember when the truckers were protesting the mandates. You know, they had banks, some of the government seized, froze some of their banks. You had charities that were trying to help these guys, and that was frozen. So we've already seen government really overstep its bounds, as it is in the banking situation and financial sector that we have now. Can you imagine if we went to something like a central bank digital currency? So I'm glad that we're at the tip of the spear on this. I think it's really important that states stand up to fight back against some of the things that are going on, well, most of the things that are going on right now in Washington, because they don't have your best interests at heart. They have their own power at heart. They have their own agenda that they're looking to advance.
Blood clot. This not something right.